Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name is Jim Beckler, and I'm going to take a few minutes of your time to show you a really nice motorhome we have available. This actually just came on our lot, so this is fresh inventory, just came from the factory. If you're familiar with Tiffin, you know that they're made kind of off the beaten path. These are made in Red Bay, Alabama, so it's not typically where a motorhome mecca, you know, somewhere in Indiana or even out here in the West where a lot of manufacturers are located. One of the things, the advantages of that is the fact that since they are a little bit out of their own, on their own, they build a lot of their motorhomes themselves. So they don't just buy parts from somebody and assemble them. They're a true manufacturer. So a lot of what the you see on one of these motorhomes, they actually manufacture themselves. They even build their own windows. They have their own plant where they do their windows. So they're not reliant on a lot of other people to produce product for them to be able to produce their motorhome. So it gives you more consistent quality, and it's much easier to get parts. In fact, a lot of the when I was back at the factory a couple years ago, they showed us in a corner of the one of the areas that they walked us through, there were entry doors for coaches that were, you know, went back 20 years. So they like to keep parts on hand just in case somebody has the need for say for example an entry door on a, you know, 20 year old motorhome. They call up and they'll have one available. And since they manufacture the parts themselves, even if they didn't have it, they could probably reproduce it because they'd have the original plans and the prints. So if you haven't visited the factory, it's quite a place. It really has a lot of state-of-the-art equipment. They build a great product, that's the bottom line. Great reputation for customer service. I know I haven't showed you much about the coach yet, but, and you may already know this, most Tiffin owners are people that are best advertisers, so it's a good company and a good product. This is actually a fairly new floor plan for them. It's a 34 PA. So it's a nice mid-sized motorhome, Class A coach, built on a Ford chassis, so this has got the V10 in it, so you got plenty of power. It's actually a 26,000 pound chassis, so this is the largest gas chassis that we've actually had in here. They just made a change. Prior to this, it was 24,000 pound chassis, so they've gone to a little bit bigger chassis. My understanding is they've gone to a 6-speed transmission on these motorhomes now too. So better drivability, the bigger chassis is just going to give you that much more ability to load the coach without having to feel like you're overloading it. And the heavier chassis typically ride nicer too. One of the other things that's nice about it is you do have the bigger tires. So you got 22.5 instead of, you know, 19. Some gas coaches maybe only have 19.5s. This says 22.5, same size that you'd have on a diesel motorhome. So the advantage there is you do have more contact to the ground, that roll nicer, just a better feeling motorhome as you're going down the road. You've got less bump steer and just a smoother ride and easier control of the whole unit. Full body paint on this. Tiffin does a great job on their paint. They have a relatively new paint facility that was fashioned after Mercedes-Benz of North America, a really nice downdraft system that eliminates a lot of the particles when they're spraying this down. You don't get a lot of particulates in the air. They use at least two coats of clear coat on all their coaches. Some of them have as much as four. So depending on the paint scheme and the model, you're going to have good, they all have good quality paint. Some are just a little bit higher end than the others. I like the fact it does have backup monitors on your mirrors now too. The side view cameras are right in your mirror, so you got a backup on the back coach. We'll see that in just a minute, but you also have side view cameras too. As we walk through the side of the coach here, notice how the doors open up like a car door. They swing out. As you can see, the compartments are large, but there's also pass-through on top. So just about every one of these compartments has a pass-through, so you can load stuff up above there. A great place to put maybe a ladder or lawn chairs, things of that nature. They even manufacture a lot of their own plastics. These This cargo doors, they make these themselves, so they're, again, they don't have to worry about trying to get parts. If you ever have any problems with one of these doors, they can replace it very easily. They're also insulated. If you can come around here, you can look down inside of that, where that latch is, you can see that there's a solid block foam insulation. So this entire door panel inside has solid block insulation, so you're really insulated well. So when you put your stuff down here, you know that it's going to be protected. Even has a really nice bulb seal all around the outside of the entries too. This one has central vac, which you can see right there. There's your fresh water tank. I like the fact they put the sensors on the outside now instead of the inside, so you don't have to worry about getting corroded and giving you bad sending readings. They put a nice alloy wheel on here, not just wheel covers. Large propane tank. Again, pass-through storage up above, and then back in here you also have pass-through storage. My understanding is this material, as when I was back at the factory, they were talking about this. This is something that they've done themselves. It's a kind of like a spray-in bed liner. They call it, back in Alabama where they build these, they call that gator hide. So that's their name for it. And it's really durable, tough, easy to clean. You know, and it's a little bit of a rough surface, so things don't slide on it real easy, easier than you'd want them to. Nice rear cap, has a solid one-piece cap on the back and the front. Backup monitor, which we talked about, ladder to get up on top. They do use a one-piece fiberglass roof on all their Tiffin motorhomes, so it's already formed, shaped. In fact, if you go to the factory, you can see they have a table where all these roofs are sitting before they drop them down on top of the motorhome, and you can see how they're shaped. One of the things that really impressed me when I was there is I noticed that where that roof comes down from the top and makes the corner, right in that middle area, the fiberglass was a lot thicker. So the reason they do that, obviously that's going to be your probably the most potential stress on the motorhome, because it's just going down the road. You know, they move back and forth. It's like a box on wheels. So added stability is it's just going to add to less stress, less likely that you'll have any issues with that. So good engineering on these motorhomes. Tiffin has a great reputation. You know, their philosophy is if we build it, we're going to stand behind it. And so they don't cut corners. If they're going to stand behind it, they're going to build something that's going to hold up. 50 amp service, even has a surge protector built in to protect the appliances and everything inside. Has a 7,000 watt generator. This one has the upgraded generator that gives you more power going into your coach. Especially this one has two air conditioners. The front air conditioner on this unit is has a heat pump system too, which is really makes it nice. So we usually order these with the bigger generator just for that reason. Your wet bay is real simple, easy to use, but everything's right there. Has a whole house water filter. You can see down back there. The water pump's right there, easy to get to. So easy hookup for your black tank, for your sewer hose and all that. Even has a spot here where you can switch for your water pump, so you can turn your water pump on from out here too. And then on these compartments over here, just opposite of your passenger side, you've got more storage access to your pass-through. I think your batteries are going to be down in here. What? That's not. That's your inverter here. So this has a, looks like this one has a Magnum inverter. So this is a PureSign inverter. Maybe this is Now there's your system for your hydraulics. The jacks on this are hydraulics. So you got auto level jacks. This one's equipped with a entry door on the driver's side also. Well, let's take a look inside. You know, I mentioned earlier this has a 26,000 pound chassis, so a nice heavy duty chassis. You can see the controls are displayed right out here, very user friendly. Your leveling jacks controls are right there, easy to get to. Your backup monitor is right here. Your sound system's right there. This one's actually equipped with it's XM radio capable, and has an electric power awning or a power shades on the front, I should say. So your front shades are operated. You got a night shade, both shades are operated right from here. So if you get ready to turn in for the night, you can just run that shade down, give you a nice privacy, all the other shades pulled down manually. Got storage up front here also. Both the front seats are going to spin around too, so you can use this as part of your furniture. Both these seats are power too. Both your driver and passenger seats are electric. Nice little slope sofa. This actually does make into a bed also. Notice all the storage up above the sofa. You do have a huge amount of storage. Good windows, lots of lighting. Has a nice size TV. Got storage down below here also. You know, it comes with a little coffee table too that folds up. Dinette booth has storage underneath also, which on both sides, this will make into a sleeper too. You can drop this table down and fill this area in here for another bed. They do a really nice job on their woodwork too. As I mentioned, the factory, they have their own wood shop, so they manufacture all their own cabinets. They have some really impressive lathe machines there that produce all their cabinets. Their woodwork is done in-house. In fact, they do such a good job that I was told when I was there that if they decided tomorrow to quit building motorhomes, they could start building furniture. They have the wherewithal to do that, the equipment and the know-how. Nice full extension drawers. Good amount of counter space in here too. With notice all the 110 outlets, right? There's three of them right there and in your kitchen area, easy to get to. Solid surface countertops, a good material, stainless steel sinks. You have two nice deep sinks with residential style faucets. Now this unit actually does have convection microwave and a gas oven as well. So you have the three burner stovetop, gas oven, and the convection microwave that you can use for cooking. Some people like to spend time in their unit preparing meals, and so this has got a good layout for that. Matter of fact, look at the refrigerator that it comes with. It's a residential style refrigerator, huge capacity, with the freezer down below. So you can be out on the road for quite a while and not have to go to the store every other day. Look at that bathroom, nice bathroom area. Excuse me. I guess it's best if we unlock it first before we try to open it. Nice stand-up shower. I like the tile floor that they use in this too, so it's really a nice, easy to clean flooring. It does come with a washer and dryer. Already set up. bathroom area does also have a lot of storage. Nice. Really big pantry. Again, more drawers that pull out quite a ways. It's a nice little bedroom suite. Again, plenty of drawers, lots of storage. Has a nice deep closet. And it's got a little laundry basket here as well. TV's mounted back here. It comes out, swivels around. It's already set up with your, it's got a 3D Blu-ray player already in it. And they do come with a DirecTV receiver box. So if you already have DirecTV, you'll have another receiver. You know, if you choose a different satellite provider, then of course you can, it can be changed out, but they do provide that as part of the motorhome. Really nice memory foam bed. We do have the bedding with it. It's all in here. This coach actually just came in a day or so ago, so we haven't really had a chance to set everything up, but I wanted to give you an opportunity to take a look, realize what we have here, and because this just might be the run for you. This is a great floor plan. A lot of people like the idea of having a motorhome that's in that mid-30 range. It's big enough to where, you know, you have the washer dryer, you've got a good open floor plan, but it's not so big that maybe you have some troubles getting into some of the places that you like to go with, you know, if you go with a bigger motorhome. So I'd love to tell you a little bit more about it. Maybe you have some questions still. Maybe you want to see what you could do about trading the coach you have now for something like this. I'd be glad to help. I've been with the RV Corral now for a little over 9 years, and so I feel like this is a good company to do business with. Otherwise I wouldn't have stayed here. So if you would ask for me, I'd sure appreciate it. I'd be glad to help. My name again is Jim Beckler, and you can reach me on my direct line at 541-510-1017. Thanks for your time, and talk to you later.